Hey guys, how you doing? I just wanted to show you my strap bar that I made for my daughter during all this quarantine stuff. I'll kind of tell you what I did, and this is the finished product. It just took me a couple weeks to build because of all this rain and stuff like that. I don't even think the cement is set yet, dry yet. So basically what I did was I took a 4-inch by 6-inch by 12-foot long beam, two of them. I dug down pretty much as I could fit my arm down there with a one-man auger, threw roots and rocks, took a little bit to get down there. What I did before, this is a 3/4 inch, just a steel pipe you could get. I got everything from Home Depot. And what I did was I drilled holes through the top in the middle, about 1 foot down. And then I got these end things that screw onto the end of the pole. And then what I did was I screwed the cap on. Now I wanted the max amount of stability for the bar, so I put the bar through the beam and then I attached it on the other side. And I did that to both sides. You can see here kind of what it looks like. I also ran into some problems because I dug the holes for 6 feet because I thought I was gonna get a 6 foot pole, and my wife brings home a 5 foot. So if you see the holes here, I ended up getting down about 27 to 29 inches per hole, and I had to keep digging in and in on both sides. But I ended up fitting 3 bags each of the Quikrete, and all I did was I poured it in there, and then there was water in there from the rain, so I had to get a big cup and take a lot of the water out. But so I dumped it in there, the Quikrete, and then I poured a little water back in there. So that was probably about a week ago, maybe a little longer, a week and a couple days, and it's still tacky because it's been raining so much here. But my daughter got on, she did a couple swings and a giant and stuff, and it moved a little too much for my liking. So I put these stability legs on here, and these are 4x4x8. I got 3 of them. So what I did is I basically cut them in half, cut 2 45-degree angles on each end, and I ended up buying the wrong clamps. These were kind of like for an edge to go like right here. So I had to flatten them out to kind of make this work. This one, it looks kind of crazy on there. But I figure if I can make it work, I'll make it work without having to take them back and just prolonging the process. But I put as many screws in there as I can for maximum support on each side here. And I'll show you this hole over here, so you can see the concrete down there. Now 3 bags per post. And let me tell you, I debated on whether or not to do the foam. And I watched a bunch of videos on YouTube, and I just didn't feel that the foam would support the weight of the beams enough. And that's why I went with the Quikrete, as opposed to like the, I think it's like K2 foam, like post foam or something like that. So I'm not sure if I made it hard on myself or not, but I put the pole in the post first. So I put the pole on each, like together on each post, and then put it in the hole. And I tried leveling it out, and I was gonna secure it both at the same time, but I had so much trouble doing it. I'm not an idiot, but I learned from this process. Anyway, so I ended up leveling out one post at a time, letting that kind of dry for a day or two, and then did the other post. and it's set in there. It's pretty dry, but I don't think the cement is dry enough to not have these legs on it. But even so, if it was dry, I'd probably put the legs on it anyway. Just because if my daughter's up there flying around on this thing, her and her friends, maybe her coach will come over and do some practice with her. I don't want this bar like flying everywhere, moving a lot and stuff like that. So, what I did also was I took I guess it would be a 1-inch, PVC pipe, and I cut it 2 feet. And so I put it over the 3/4-inch bar, and it goes around pretty well. So if you're making one of these things, try to put it as close to like the strap bar at the gym, my daughter's gym, as possible. And some other people were making these online, so we ended up going with a 3/4-inch pipe and then the 1-inch PVC pipe to go around, and that makes her able to go around and around doing her giants and stuff. So all in all, I didn't do this on a budget. I kind of did it for what I thought would be durable and safe for, you know, whoever's going to be on this thing. So I want to say I spent anywhere maybe around $150 to $200, give or take some of that. So if you're wanting to do one of these things, look at some videos online and do a little research, and good luck with your pole. And I hope this video was useful to some of you who are thinking about doing these things. And by the way, these are treated boards, so I'm hoping that you know, they last a little while. I may do some more heavy duty stain, possibly paint. But like I said, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like it, subscribe and leave me a comment and let me know how I did. I'll post a video of my daughter on this thing and see how it goes. Anyway, hope you all are safe out there, and see you next time. Have a good night.